Sega. Oh, nope, this is a Nintendo. Alright, so this Nintendo came back for one primary reason. It is having a little bit of difficulty playing some games. We were able to get it work by jiggling the cartridge, but we don't want that. We want to get it to work as good as possible. Now, like I have told the owner and the client, we can replace the cartridge connector. That's not a problem, but I do firmly believe we can probably restore the connector also, just as easily. I don't do the boiling trick unless absolutely necessary, but I don't really think it's needed. I just think it just needs a tougher cleaning, which I might be able to rig something together to really rigorously clean those connectors. If we have to replace it, though, that will be done, obviously. However, one of the things I want to do real quick, though, and it was one of the things I promised the client because of this issue and it coming back, I am going to do the sound expansion mod on it. I have already actually had this thing taken apart already because I was testing the sound expansion mod using some different resistors and things like that just to make sure it was going to work in the first place. Sometimes on the motherboard, other things can cause issues, like a bad cap, like a bad filter cap may not pass the audio because it's never been used. The expansion passer has never really been used on these things, so a lot of times you may not even know that they may not work. But as I expected, though, it worked just fine. So now we have some resistors over here that you can't really see, but there they are, right there. We're going to solder in, but I don't know the values offhand of these resistors, and there's a range we need to get, so we will obtain that information once we get into the console. So let me just take the shell off, and I actually can take the metal off right now, because you want to take the RFI shielding off. You don't want that in the way. Ow, my shoulder just popped. Yeah, I'm getting old, man. I'm in my 30s now. It's kind of funny. I started my YouTube account, I think, when I was still a teenager. Actually, that's not funny. That's actually kind of sad and scary. Actually, I might have been 20 or 21. Can't remember offhand. Time flies, unfortunately, and you forget things. As long as I don't have dementia. If I have dementia, it better be space dementia. Because then I could sing along to the Muse song and be like, hey, I can relate. Too bad I don't have any H8 CPUs. If you don't get that reference, you are not a true Muse fan. In fact, I am probably saying the band name incorrectly because of my accent. I have like a hybrid of New England and Southern, and it makes some really weird, interesting choices of words. Muse is technically how you say it, but I always say Muse. Alright, this is off. No, it's not. Actually, yes, it is. I was gonna say, I was like, I'm pretty certain I did all of it. Now I gotta get the cartridge connector off. There will be three screws on each side. And always take note, one of them is actually longer than the other. You just want to always make sure which one is the longer one. That is most likely going to be the silver one. It is a different color, but just think of it this way. On the side of the connector, the side of the ZIF socket, it's the middle one. Just remember, silver goes in middle. That's all you need to know. As long as the screws on your console are silver. I just forgot. Sometimes it may not be made of the same materials. I think they use... Oh, crap. Good thing for magnetic screwdrivers. Some people are like, oh, you're using magnetic screwdrivers on a computer? That ain't good. You're going to mess up that hard drive. Well, that sounded a little bit like Hank Hill, didn't it? These magnetic screwdrivers are not really going to harm your hard drives at all. They'd have to be a really strong magnetic field to actually do that. Proof of it? Wave this over your floppy disk. And then try to read your floppy disks, if you have a floppy drive anymore. Tells you how old I am. I assume everyone still has one. Anyway, it's not going to mess it up. Come on. It's not strong enough. Alright, let's get this socket out of there. It is always so tricky to get them out, but there's the trick. You just got to mind the front. Alright, So there's going to be two pins here on this board. I can't remember offhand. I think it's like between 3 and 7. I'll have to double check. And that's where I'm going to solder the resistor to. So I'm actually going to go ahead and do have this here. Good. Just going to wipe down real quick. And to prep the surface, I actually put it down electrical tape. This is a thicker, non-UL listed electrical tape, which I prefer for this kind of job. You're not going to run into an issue where the resistor is going to hit the ground, you know, hit and short something out, but I like to always take precautions anyway. You know what they say, better safe than sorry, and, well, why be sorry? Alright, where's my screwdriver? I promise I got enough sleep this time. Maybe not. I kept waking up because I fell asleep with Match Game 78 on buzzer on. And then woke up saying, survey says? No, I actually really did that, yesterday. I did that yesterday. I fell asleep with Family Feud on and woke up in the middle of the night saying, survey says. Don't ask me how I know. Sometimes I actually do remember some of the things I say when I wake up. Alright, perfect. Doesn't really get in the way, and it'll be perfect. So I always lay that down so that way the resistor doesn't have an issue. So what I do need to do now is go on the computer and find out what pins it is and what the value is. I always look at the comments to see what resistor values people have found to work better, because I would prefer it to be as perfect as possible for my clients. I really do not like being a cheapskate on these things. I may be a Sega fanboy and hate Nintendos, but come on. These things are vintage and they're awesome. They have good games. Alright, so I thought 3 and 7, it's actually 3 and 9. So what I'm going to use is I'm going to actually put a little pen mark to where 3 and 9 is. And 9. So 1, 2, 3. Let's put that pen mark right there. Really, my pen doesn't work? Are you freaking kidding me? There it goes. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Here we go. I'm going to verify it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yep. You know, as they say, measure twice, cut once. That's how I do it. And I always mark it with a pen. Once it's done, I clean off the pen. You know. I mean, the pen's not even going to do anything. They write on these things with pens and markers from the factory. And I'm not doing, you know what? You don't even have to. So, it's fine. It's fine. There's no reason to be that anal about it. They say the resistor you want is between 24 and up to 56K. They say pick a range in the middle. Well, what do the comments say? I mean, I can tell you right now, a lower impedance is going to be louder than a higher impedance, because it's basically just connecting through, so this isn't like pulling down to ground, where higher would... No, it's still the same, actually, anyway. What do the comments say? I want it to work though also with the legit VRC6 cartridge if he uses like an import adapter with like Castlevania 3. So I really do want to choose a good middle ground here. Someone's it looks like someone said around 40K, but it looks like 60K was okay. I mean, they're even saying at 56K it's a little bit on the loud side, so let's take a look at these resistors we have, first of all. I need a resistor calculator because I can't remember the values. I've tried to remember them. They're not even that hard, but I always get caught in the multipliers on these things. So, the first resistor I have here is orange, 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 gold. Well, I have a feeling that might not be enough. Orange, 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 gold. That's actually 33k ohms. This is decent. I might need to double it though. But what's this other one I have? The other resistor I have is brown, black, orange, gold. Brown, black, orange, gold. That's 10k. So let's do this. Let's do this. I'm going to actually take these two resistors and put them in series. So that'll actually add 10k ohms to that. Let's see. Well, actually, I have two 10k ohms. I have two of each. You know what? Let's double up the first one, actually. Which was, I already forget these things. That was 33, so that would be 66k ohms. Someone said on imports, even 90k ohms sounds good. So, I mean, the EverDrive doesn't need a 90k ohm, then it would be too soft. So here's the middle ground. Because it's more likely going to be using a flash cart than a import. Because if you can get a flash cart, then why import them? Well, for collection purposes, but you can use the EverDrive to play the same game just fine. So we're going to go with this middle ground. So now what we need to do is actually solder these together. So I need my helping hands. I wish I did have a beer right now. I usually don't work and drink beer at the same time, but one beer doesn't hurt. Especially to get you going. Alright, I'm going to zoom in for you guys. This is all happening live and in real time, in case you haven't realized. Because I think live and real time is awesome. And including, let's do some manual focusing, because that is not... Wow, camera! Turn off automatic focus, and it's like, screw you. That legitimately is as good as it's going to get. That's fine. So I'll actually use this. I'll push this back a little bit so it gets things in focus. Let's move it a little bit closer to me at least. Are you still in focus? You are decent enough to work with. All right. Helping hands. There we go. Make sure the iron is even tinned. Yeah, it is. Well, no, it's not, actually. I gotta tin my iron first. I'm tinning it off camera because the iron holder is actually off to the side, and I'm not gonna... I have a short power cable on it, so... You always want a nice, shiny tip. Just... Alright. I'm going to cut this lead a little short because I'm actually going to do this. Like I said, this is going in series. So I'm just cutting this lead a little short. It's going to actually tie around the other one. There we go. These are not proper use of these scissors. These are actually snips for things like Ethernet cables and things. I am not using them properly. And I don't care. Okay. This is the only hardest part, is trying to get these to twist around each other. I like to twist them around. There are so many different ways you can do this, but I like to do like a little twist around, but unfortunately they're not going to play with me very well, so I'll tin them each, and then I'll just solder them together, like, manually. Who the hell cares? As long as it works, and works well. And there are some people that don't even solder, and I'm like, I don't know why you don't even solder. Why? Everyone has their own ways of doing it, and there are right ways and there are wrong ways, but there are a lot of right ways. And a lot of wrong ways. I'm just gonna tin this real quick. Done. Woo! Okay, maybe having that fan on was a bad idea. Blow it in my face, why don't you? Lead. Gotta love lead. Would you like some lead poisoning with that? I don't use lead-free solder. I am not green, because I've seen what lead-free solder does, and I'm not a fan of things coming back because they sucked. You know, this is really difficult to solder like this on camera for you guys. I'm sorry. Maybe I'll have to actually reposition that camera. Let's do that. Let's reposition this. Oh yeah, I'm gonna have to totally refocus this now, aren't I? Because it's a little bit easier for me to solder like this. Let's see, do I need to refocus? I do not need to refocus. That is a Christmas and a half miracle. Cool. All right, that part's done. I'm gonna actually solder this both together, so I'm gonna use the helping hands to... Wow, I really do suck at actually making this visible for you guys. I am so sorry. I just don't have a top-down camera. I really wish I did. Top-down camera really would actually help. So let's do that. That'll be nice. That's. I just want to keep them as like equal as possible. A good way to do it would be to ultimately actually twist them around. But these leads are so short, it's not easy. I don't like to have like a pointy end sticking out. I like to keep it like a smooth curve, not twisted together with one pointy end sticking out one way. I don't think that looks good. And I did that on my YM3438 mod on my Sega, and I never liked it. I was never happy with that result. I will actually properly do that. It doesn't matter, but like I said, I really do like the work looking good. So I'm gonna go ahead and... There really is no way to do this easily on camera. A little bit extra solder. I'll just clean the tip, wipe it down, and it will probably suck it right up. Now I'm using solder that has flux already technically built in, so... I don't flux it ahead of time because I don't have to with this. There we go. See? It just picks it right up. It works really good. I really do like the solder. And it's actually Radio Shack solder, believe it or not. So that rosin core thing going on. That might not actually be flux. But it works so well. And yeah, it's very mechanically secure. It's not going anywhere. And it looks really, really good. So perfect. Now we just solder this resistor onto the Nintendo mainboard. So what I'm gonna do, if it was through hole stuff, I would snip it after I solder it through the hole. But this is a little bit different, and you can't see shit. Okay. Let's zoom in a little bit on that. You're at the max, aren't you? This is all real time. I'm not doing this edited whatsoever. There we go. So I'm gonna put it through here. I'm gonna probably sit off to... No, I can't. So there's gonna be... I have two pins marked. It is pin 3 and pin 9. So now what I need to do is actually do it like this. Actually, this might work a little bit better. I'm just gonna basically shape this around so like a little curve so it goes to 9. So that's pin 3. That'll go that way. Stay on the electrical tape too. And the part that I soldered, you can't really change it now at this point. Actually, yeah, I can. That was good soldering on my part. I actually did keep it there. So actually, here we go. I'm gonna solder it this way. And then it will rest basically neatly like that. And that's how I'm gonna do it. I have proper snips so I can cut it after I solder it, but I can't find it. I used it for something and then I lost it, and I honestly do not know where the hell I put it. So I'm gonna actually have to cut this down to size. Which is fine. I can do that. Done. And it's not trivial to do. Alright, and I want it to press down so it goes nice and flat with the main board. That way we don't have any issues soldering. Good. But before I actually solder it, I need to tin it. Once again, I gotta tin these ends. Helps it stick better. I'll just do that off camera and do it nice and quick. Because you've already seen how I tin things. You don't need to see it again. I gotta tin my iron first though. A lot of people like, so do you use a sponge or do you use that brass filling thing, whatever it's called? I honestly don't know what it's called. I prefer a sponge. I am a sponge person. Please don't drip. Please don't drip. I used a little bit too much. I'm going over my leg. I don't need to burn my leg. I don't really need to retin the contacts here on the main board, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Just to get a little extra solder, it will help me later. Do you see this? Do you see it? Hi, my amplifier. Works better this way. This solder really does not actually want to work. Here we go. Okay, good. I'm not trying to create a blob. I'm just actually literally trying to just tin it a little bit so it actually has the way it flows a little better, because this solder hasn't been soldered in so long, and I actually find that a lot of times it doesn't want to melt as easily as I'd like it to. So by doing this, it actually helps me a lot. All right, cool. Can you see? Yes, you can. You can see good enough. And I bridged that side, but I'll take care of that after I do this one. I'll just do the other side real quick, and then I'll take care of that. There we go. Alright, I'll take care of that bridge. It's a solder sucker. I'll just start again. My solder sucker broke. Okay. Tip just came off. Nice. I'll fix that later. I don't need it anymore though, so that's good. It actually looks like it's actually now properly soldered, but I am going to take care of that, and no, it's actually not soldered, so I will definitely be taking care of that now. Come on. There we go. Perfect. Gently press this down so it lays flush as much as you can. I mean, you're not going to get it really all that perfect. You just don't want it pushing the bottom of the cartridge connector, which I don't think it is. That's pretty flat.
So now that's pins 3 and 9, that's taken care of. And I don't have snips, but that's fine. And let me look at this bottom. Yeah, that's not gonna hit at all. I just wanna test it anyway. Make sure it doesn't hit. I'll be able to tell if I press it down and it pushes up a little bit, then it's hitting the bottom. So I'm just gonna check real quick. Come on. Nope. Good. All right, that's all done. I can actually solder this together. I can screw the machine back together and now just work on the cartridge connector, which is going to be in... I'm just going to do that off camera. I'm not going to bother fixing it on camera because you've already seen how I do that, but I never really showed I never showed this mod. So let me just get everything back together and... We are all done. So everyone have a good one. That is a sound expansion mod being installed.